tonight to recognize great journalism and the impact that great journalism has made in Georgia, the United States, and even the world. When I began my career as a journalist at the Atlanta Journal-Constitution 25 years ago, I typed stories into a green A-Tech screen. I carried a pager. I called editors from payphones. I once used a bag phone to dictate scenes of looting from Eastern Street. A bag phone. Eventually, I filed stories for the road using a portable word processor, which transmitted words digitally through rubber cups connected to a telephone receiver. Just two decades later at Bloomberg News, I could do my entire job covering multinational food and beverage companies from an iPhone. And sometimes I had to. As journalists, we really do live in extraordinary times. Technology has radically and fundamentally changed how we report, write, and present the news. It has changed the strategies behind the business of news. It has changed how we think about news. This is, of course, a mixed bag of opportunities and challenges. We as journalists can move faster than ever, but we also face increasing pressure to sometimes move faster than we should. As beneficial as speed can be, and indeed, it can save lives, speed also can be the enemy of thought and perspective and fairness. But we shouldn't think that our modern times are so special. Just think about the many ways that radio and later television changed us and our industry. Consider how centuries of journalists have adapted to technology and created new business models. I mean, if you think about it, journalism used to be practiced through oral tradition and on cave walls. All of these journalists faced new challenges as well, and they all faced critics. But what has always been true, then and now, is that no matter the form or forum, the practice of journalism at its core is about improving the human condition by finding and presenting facts that help people make better decisions and provide better solutions. That never changes, and the importance is undeniable. So with that in mind, the Atlanta Press Club has developed a Journalism Matters campaign to proactively address the impact of journalism. We also want to open a dialogue about our profession and how we as an industry can and should continually improve to serve our mission. In your programs, you'll find a statement the club intends to distribute and support in the coming year. I'll read it for you now. The Atlanta Press Club, almost 600 members strong, values diversity of opinion, civil discourse, and constructive criticism of institutions. These are hallmarks of a free society, and journalists serve a key role in advancing these values. People invested in their communities rely on the work of trusted and ethical journalists to help them stay informed and make decisions. Journalists are trained professionals who strive to gather information and present facts. Millions of readers, viewers, and listeners endorse this work every day with their time and attention. A free press is essential to a well-functioning society that benefits all participants, and it must be protected at all levels. Already, by being in this hall tonight, it it's clear that you value this amazing roster of Hall of Famers who have lived the mission to the fullest and serve as an example of what we are at our best. As you will see shortly, their body of work proves without a doubt that journalism matters. Thank you. So now it's my honor and pleasure to introduce your emcee for this evening. Christi Paul is the weekend anchor for CNN's Newsday. She is also a weekday anchor and reporter for HLN. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to Christi Paul.
Because it's one thing to sit in the classroom and read the books, and even if there's a TV there are so many available now on college campuses and even high school campuses. But to be there with these people like you who are being honored and who have been honored in the past, to watch you, to listen to you, what we learned from you as interns made us who we are today. And I already met an intern and a volunteer here tonight. His name is Tony Bennett. You're going to want to remember that name. He came up. He's a go-getter. He knows what he's doing. He's a junior. He's going to be a senior next year. And I wish him the best. You never know. Some of these interns could be the very people that are going to be sitting here getting awards later on. So let's give them a big round of applause. Start our show so we can honor the people we're here to honor. Thank you so much.